Hey, is anybody here? Is anybody here? Hey,
are you guys there? Hi, I'm Bryce, and I'm kind of stuck right now, but welcome to Vineyard Youth Online. I'm really glad you're here. We got a really good teaching and a really good time of worship coming up. So stick around. I'm going to because I'm stuck in this thing. So if you could help me get out, that'd be great.
Welcome to Vineyard Youth, guys. We're so glad you can make it. We're going to start with the time of worship. So if you guys can stand, sing, clap along, just worship with us to praise God.
And I searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. Man's empty praise, treasures that fade, are never enough. Then you came along and put me back together. And every desire is still satisfied here in your love. No, there's nothing better than
till I
call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day. You call my name, and I ran out of that grave. Your glorious day.
Now your mercy.
Now your mercy has saved my soul. Now your freedom is all that I know. The old and new, Jesus, when I met you,
what a day.
You called my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day. You called my name, and I ran out of that grave. Out of the darkness into your glorious day.
Yeah, sing it out.
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy, but chains break at the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan, and you called me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. But when you call my name, into your glorious day, you call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness, into your glorious day.
'Cause your power, your presence breaks down walls, and King of heaven.
Speak to us tonight, that you would do that. Help us to hear, Lord. Open our ears, God, to whatever you're saying through the message, Lord. We thank you, God. Please keep us healthy. It's in your name I pray. Amen. Well, hey, would you let us know that you're here in the chat? That would be great. Say hi.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is The Shepherd Show!
This is The Shepherd Show. On this show, we will give you breaking news, weather forecasts, good news, important stuff, a verse of the week, fun times, and also be on the lookout for special guests. Make sure to follow us so you can keep up with all of our news stories and tag us in a picture of your favorite pet to nominate it for Cute Pet of the Week. Now to the weather forecast for this weekend.
hot.
How hot is it?
Well, just avoid the outside. Although, this weekend we do have a 100% chance of a cool Mother's Day sermon by VCMP's own Pastor Brian T. Anderson. Yes, we've got, looks like, a 100% chance on Saturday at 5 p.m. and also on Sunday at 9:15 a.m. and 11 a.m. Head on over to VineyardNorthPhoenix.com to check it out.
This is Hyatt Burst Production, and if you haven't already checked out their video, why don't you head on over and do that right now?
Breaking news!
Lisa and Zach have the bestest mommy ever! This week's cute pet of the week is none other than Ranger. Stunning. Remember, to nominate your favorite pet for cute pet of the week, go ahead and leave a comment that has their picture and their name, and maybe we'll choose them next week. Now to our verse of the week. Our verse of the week this week is Isaiah 26:3. You, Lord, give perfect peace to those who keep their purpose firm and put their trust in you. The context around this verse is that the Jewish people were in Babylonia. This was the Babylonian exile. And to give them hope for a better future, God gave this verse to Isaiah to tell the people. God is giving us hope for the future now if we listen to his voice. Let's listen to that verse again, but let it really sink in this time and have a deeper meaning as you apply it to your life. You, Lord, give perfect peace to those who keep their purpose firm and put their trust in you. Amazing, isn't it? Now for a few last words. I want to wish a happy Mother's Day to all mothers everywhere.
Especially our wonderful mom. Thank you.
Check back with us next week for more news stories. And be sure to stop by the church's website at VineyardNorthPhoenix.com.
Also, don't forget to go there on Saturdays at 5 and Sundays at 9:15 and 11 a.m.
That's VineyardNorthPhoenix.com. Bye!
Welcome to Vineyard Youth Online. My name is Mickayla, and I'm one of the leaders here, and I'm super excited to talk to you guys today. We're in this new series called Habits. And last week, Bryce talked to you guys about who it is you want to be. Today, we're talking about starting habits and how we're going to get there. Now, before we jump in, I want you to think back to when we were in our norm. Right before this whole quarantine thing, we would wake up in the morning to our alarm and probably hit snooze about 1,000 times before we actually got out of bed. And we'd rush off to school. We'd go to school and it'd be the same classes at the same time every day. You had your practices at the same time every week. You knew what to expect. You had this routine, this daily routine, and you had these habits. Now, we're in this quarantine life, and all we do is sit there all day and binge Netflix. But we have these goals that we want to do, right? We want to step out of quarantine fit. And so we're work out because we have the time to do it.
There you go.
Or we'll tell ourselves, we have this goal to read and finish an entire book for once.
Do you like green eggs and ham?
Or maybe your goal is to learn something new, like play the piano. These goals, because we have all the time in the world, but it's so hard to actually do them. We have these goals similar to everybody else. But 40% of what you do is not a result of decisions, but it's a result of habits. And this is not our habit. So how do we start these habits? Well, preacher Craig Groeschel says goals don't determine success, but systems or plans do. He also said, you don't rise to the level of your goals, but you fall to the level of your systems or your plans. These plans for these goals, to step close to who you want to be. Now, what is these systems? What are these systems or these plans? It's the structure of your daily routine, your habits. Now, Daniel in the Bible is a perfect example of what these habits look like. Now, when you think of Daniel, you think of Daniel in the lion's den, and that's not really what we're talking about. We're talking about Daniel as a young teenage man, right? He's around the age similar to most of you guys. Now, Daniel was picked out along with about 100, 120 other young men to go and study under the king. Now, out of all of these young men, Daniel stood out the most. He was favored by the king. But what was so special about Daniel? He had a plan. He had these habits or this pattern that made him stand out. Let's read in Daniel 6:10. It says here, but when Daniel learned that the law had been signed, he went home and knelt down as usual in his upstairs room with its windows open towards Jerusalem. He prayed 3 times a day, just as he has always done, giving thanks to God. Daniel prayed 3 times a day. And if you look closely, it says, just as he has always done. He's always done this. Not when it was convenient, not when it was easy, but it was a habit. It was his pattern, his system. Now, I have disciplines that I do to help me go throughout my day. And one habit that I've created for myself is every single morning I make my bed, every morning. And it sounds silly, but it helps me step closer to that person that I want to be. Making my bed, I tell myself I have discipline, and then I feel productive throughout my entire day. And then I have time to do things because I'm productive, like read my Bible or spend time with God. Now, on any day that I don't make my bed and I skip out or fail on this habit that I've created for myself, the day is horrible and it's ruined. It sounds silly and it sounds dramatic, but I know you can relate. When I don't make my bed in the morning, all I do all day is think about crawling right back in bed and taking a nap, and I don't want to do anything else. So the people that I talk to, sometimes I can sound a little angry at, because again, I just want to be in bed. And I know you guys relate to that. So this small habit really pushes me towards that person that I want to be. You have to ask yourself, who does God want me to be? And then ask, what one habit do I need to start to step closer to who God wants me to be? What is that one habit? It takes 2 months to create a habit, for it to be automatic, something you do. Now, to find something, to start this habit, you have to choose something that's realistic, something that's easy. And you have to push yourself to do it for 2 months. So something for 2 months that's easy to do and realistic to do. Maybe for you, that might be reading one verse a day. As soon as you wake up, you're already on your phone, checking your messages. So open the Bible app, and there's a daily verse already there for you. Every day, just read that daily verse. And then maybe this habit will push you further and you'll want to read 2 verses, maybe 3 verses, or an entire chapter. And these small habits will launch you into this person that God wants you to be, that you want to be. Never underestimate what God can do with a small habit. Zechariah 4:10 says, do not despise these small beginnings, for the Lord rejoices to see the work begin. There is work that is starting in you and starting these small and simple habits. Let God work through you, through these small habits, so you can step closer to God. Your goals should point to who you're becoming, not where you're going or not what you're getting from it, but to where you're going and who you are stepping closer to becoming. And that should be Christ. So what small and easy habit do you need to create for yourself to step closer to God? Think about it this week. Start your habits, start your plans, and start it now. Create this pattern for yourself, and let's get started on these habits and get closer to God than ever before. Thank you guys so much for joining us at Vineyard Youth Online. I can't wait to see you guys next Wednesday.
I don't do the most, but I do a lot. I'ma make a toast, cause we still alive. No big, I feel like Pac. I shoot a shot. I'm coming in hot.